Let's start with visual. Now, by the way, you might not get a visual text in the exam. Exams are now favoring written texts. If you get an image, SSP. The first S, salience. Now, what is salience? It is the focal point of the image. Another way of putting it is where your eyes are immediately drawn. You know when something just pops out in a photo? Like there's clearly a most obvious part of the image. That's the salient point, the focal point. So if something is salient, here's a good way of remembering it for your notes. It stands out. Now, what could make something stand out? Vector lines, great. Vector lines are the lines in an image that take you into the main part of the image. The vector line could be an arm like extending out in an image. If you see a photo and the camera actually shows the arm going out like that, then that is the vector line taking you to what is salient, but the vector line, the arm is a vector line. So when you speak about salience, you have to say what makes it salient. It might be the vector line. What else could you say? Color. We could talk about lighting, but often with these things, it's not just color or lighting itself that makes something salient, it's what about those things. It's contrast that makes it stand out. So contrasting colors, or what is it called when there is light and dark in an image? There's light and dark, and the thing that's in the light becomes salient because everything else is dark around it. What's that called? Chiaroscuro. So that is a contrast between light and dark. Very, very common technique. Body language could potentially make something salient. If someone was like really expressive body language, maybe that's making them pop out. Size and scale, that goes to the composition, right? How it's composed, how it's put together. Often you see something at the front of the image and the back. What do we call those two things? Foreground, background. So one of those things makes it salient, great. Now tell me the effect of it all, or the significance of it using a key term from the question. The second S, symbolism. Obviously there might be a kind of symbol in the image. Don't forget about those. A metonym. So that means something represents a larger thing. So a phone is metonymic for technology. So you might want to put in brackets, phone, arrow, technology. Symbolism is more like a thing that is widely accepted. Does anyone know what a dove is symbolic for? Peace. A dove is an object and it links to this concept. Whereas a dove might be metonymic for animals or birds or something. There's a more direct connection between the category. So when something has a categorical link, that's a metonym. There's also something when it's like a body part, it's not really a visual one, but if it's like you're referring to someone in a poem as like a hand, like the hand went to work, the hand did his labor. But you're not saying the person, you're saying the hand. Synecdoche, that's like a body part represents the person, right? So I keep saying a hand, but I actually mean the man. And then P, let's just get P done. P is perspective. From whose perspective are we viewing the image? How are we viewing the image? Are we outside the image? Are we experiencing it from the point of view of the subject? From what kind of angle or perspective are we looking at the image, and why is that important?